Welcome to a brand new episode. I'm driving home. In case you're curious where I am, I'm on Craycroft, getting ready to pass north onto River as I head towards Sunrise. I have a couple of options driving home now, and it doesn't matter to you. You don't care about my drive home. But you are watching this, so I'll try to give you something of value and substance. I want to preface by saying that I don't like to fly. So the whole TSA pat-down scanner thing hasn't garnered a huge amount of interest with me. And again, I've mentioned this on the show. I understand why people are frustrated by it. And at the same time, I probably would be too if my boys or my wife were subject to pat-downs where they were being intrusive. But then again, if I have the option, I'll go through the scanner. I don't care. I do have a question, though, which ought to be interesting. When it comes to the scanner, it only picks up on hard objects. So I've got a titanium valve in my heart, plus I've got staples in my knee from when I hyperextended my knee back when I was like 21. So are those going to go off, and are they going to wonder what that ring is that keeps going popping and closing in the scanner thing? I'm sure that it won't cause a problem in the end. Although I the one thing I wanted to bring up in regards to all this is that no one's talking about. David Gartenstein-Ross mentioned it this morning. He thinks that all the money that we're spending on this is ridiculous because the terrorists are going to find a way to do the damage that they're going to do, regardless of how many people we run through, you know, nudie scanners and pat down at the airport. But, you know, how much scrutiny are we giving to those that are working, you know, at the airport facilities themselves? I mean, how easy is it to get a job working for an airport and then eventually cause some damage because you have access to that airport or to airplanes, right? I mean, if anything, this whole recent controversy over the TSA scanners has been stemming from what? The terrorists continuing to try to kill the infidel. And they're very patient at doing so. I mean, the fact that the Yemeni-based Al-Qaeda would go and spend the $4,200, which isn't a lot of money, to send these toner cartridges, which they really didn't anticipate blowing up, simply because they wanted to do damage to us economically and have us spent money. I mean, it shows you just how patient these guys are in causing America harm. And they have. They're costing us, you know, millions, if not billions of dollars in wasted security. These guys are methodical. They are absolutely methodical. They're looking at other ways to go and do us harm rather than a big catastrophic 9/11 type event. So who's to say they wouldn't try to go and infiltrate an airport and put people in there to do something wrong, which again would make all of these security measures pointless at this point in time. Now, it doesn't bother me. I don't think they should be doing them. I do think it's pointless. But at the same time, I don't mind going through a scanner. If somebody's going to get their jollies off of seeing an X-ray of my body, they've got, you know, issues beyond anything that I care about. That's their own problem. But at the same time, unfortunately, we have a government right now, and we have an administration in the Obama administration that isn't taking this seriously, that constantly looks at the threat of terrorism, calls it something different, and doesn't do what is necessary to go and get the bad guys. And the bad guys know it, and they're trying to take advantage of us. All right, there you go. There's a webisode. I've talked enough. I still contend that after the holidays are over, you're not going to see nearly as much attention paid to this, and I bet the security measures go back to what they were. I still believe that this is all because there's a looming threat that we're not aware of, and this is all a cover-your-ass move, CYA move by the government to make sure that when something potentially does happen or they try to do us harm, they've got their bases covered. See, look, we did what was necessary, right? Sure, we groped you, but we had to. The government's keeping you safe. Vote liberal. Yeah. Ultimately, what's that? Yeah. Ultimately, what's it come down to? That again. All right. Thanks for watching. Special Thanksgiving Day programming for your Thanksgiving Day. And then on Friday, James T. Harris is filling in for me. So I always look forward to having James T. fill in. I always feel confident when he does so. Catch his show out Sunday nights right here on 104.1 The Truth. Thanks for watching, and talk to you later. Bye.